about high performance culture, which leads to high performance organizations. And with this, it brings me to the first, I would want to involve our first panelist, that is Mr. Rupesh Tripathi. That what do you think needs to be done in this uncertain world that we are living in? How do you think we could get to that, what is required to get to this high performing teams, high performance culture?
Thank you, Shwani. And yeah, I completely agree with you. I think this is such a broad topic, we can just complete, maybe spend an entire course discussing this. But to the narrow question that you rightly has put up in terms of how do we, what makes organizations high performing in the current scenario and as we move towards the future with everything that's going around, whether we call it VUCA, whether we call it technical evolution, technological evolution, industry 4.0, etc., etc. My take on this is, I got to this while reading this book, and if you haven't absolutely picked it up, there's a book by Dr. Carol Dweck called Mindsets. And what it says is, individuals who have a growth mindset vis-a-vis a fixed mindset tend to be more successful. Right, and the way she defines growth mindset is someone who is always learning, is always evolving, who does not rely on their basic competencies and capabilities, but continue to grow and learn and as against being fixed. I think that's exactly what is required even for an organizational context. Organizations who kind of rely on what was working for them, what were their USPs, as they say, or the star products, as they say, have failed. And there are enough and more of examples around that, recent being Kodak. Right? Now, there was this survey that was done for Fortune 500 companies. I think PwC did it, asking the CEOs. The question was, the insight was that 56% of the CEOs said that the disruption in their industry is going to come by an organization who is not even part of that industry, right? So what Uber did to transport, what Airbnb did to hospitality, what Reliance did to telecom in India, just taking a few examples. Unless an organization has that mindset of continuously learning from what's working, what's not working, continuing to evolve, continuing to change, they will lose this race, right? And I'll quickly talk through two examples coming from the organization that I'm working now and the previous organization. So let me talk about the one where I was before I joined IHS Market. That was Accenture. Now, the behemoth of an organization, 350,000 people at that time, I think now they're close to 500,000. Everything working absolutely fine, they are delivering to internal targets, they are beating the street, they are truly high performing organization. And one fine day you would realize that they have completely changed their operating model, they have changed their org structure, they have changed their leadership alignment, and this would just keep happening. Right? And you would just shudder to think, how would we do a change management in that kind of an organization, that size of an organization, but that was something that they had completely mastered. Right, and that led to them always staying ahead of the curve, whether what they did with technology services, what they're doing, they did with digital, what they're doing with AI and robotics right now. Classic example of how continuously changing, even if things are working for you, keeps you ahead of the game. My current organization, so 2 years back I was part of a firm called Market. It's a financial information services firm, again doing really well. But continues to change through acquisition and product innovation. Now, this period, 2015, there was just a lot of consolidations that were happening in the financial information space, a lot of mergers, acquisitions. And what Market did was went and merged with a firm called IHS. What's unique about that merger is there was not a single client which was common between these two firms. Both of them were in the information services business, but Market was financial services, and I just was energy and auto and defense and government, right? So as a result of that, in last less than 2 years, our stock price has doubled, right? So that's another example of not just keep keep doing what you're doing, but trying to figure out how to stay ahead of the curve. But that's not easy. To your question of saying, it's fine, but how do you get there? And that's where the three things that we can talk about more as we go along: culture, colleague, and capabilities. Right? How do you have a culture which promotes this? Right? How do you have a culture which promotes innovation, curiosity, which rewards dissent and disagreements, rather than saying that you've got to be yes man? A culture that rewards effort with right intent rather than only outcomes. How do you really build that culture which leads all the colleagues and the leadership ready to continue in this journey? The second is colleagues, what kind of people that you hire. And Dr. Ritwan had touched upon that, right? It's no longer about, you are from IIM, you are from Excel, or you are from Harvard, or you have worked in a similar industry for the last 20 years, you've got to be able to do it. We are now hiring people who have basic intellectual curiosity, who want to continue to learn, who are risk-taking, who can draw insights by looking at various data points, and who has that basic hunger in there. Right? And the last part is capabilities, again, not in the way Dr. Anand mentioned, but capabilities that the organization need to develop in their various functions. And let me talk about HR, right? I think HR has lagged behind the whole innovation curve in the last decade or so. We are still talking about David's model of COEs and HRBP. And while we have digitized most of the stuff that we are doing, we are still doing fairly complex stuff. We are not making life easy for our colleagues who are used to one-click Uber and one-click Amazon and that kind of an experience. So the change management capability, the employee experience that we need to build as HR function is something that will continue to support this culture and support the organization mindset of being growth. So happy to talk through that as we go around the table, but this is my one key